ग्रीटिंग्स, वी आर ग्रुप नंबर 23। ग्रुप मेंबर्स आर माई सेल्फ आकांक्षा वाडेकर, वेदांत शिंदे, वरुण कुलकर्णी। प्रोजेक्ट नेम इज सलाइन मॉनिटर, गाइडेड बाय प्रोफेसर हर्षली माने। दीस आर द आउटलाइन ऑफ द प्रेजेंटेशन। इंट्रोडक्शन। ऑलमोस्ट इन ऑल हॉस्पिटल्स एंड नर्स इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर मॉनिटरिंग द इलेक्ट्रोलाइट बॉटल लेवल, but unfortunately most of the time the observer may forget to change the bottle at the correct time due to their busy schedule. To overcome this critical situation, an IoT based automatic alerting and indicating device is proposed. In literature survey, we have condensed information of the research papers for our project. In 2018, Olavle and colleagues proposed a device that measures IV bottle level using a load cell and upon reaching a volume of 20 ml sends an alert. Similarly, all other papers are reviewed and conclusions were drawn. Gap identification. The hospital have a huge influx of patients. The patient find it tough to get in touch with nurse to notify them of the low fluid level in their saline. IV bottle has to be checked regularly by nurses. It is quite often the case that hospital are understaffed and nurses have to attend to an unmanageable number of patients simultaneously. Problem statement is to create an IoT-based automatic alerting and indicating device for monitoring the electrolyte bottle level. Objectives are to design, implement, and test an embedded system application to detect the level of IV bottle, to notify the user when bottle level is low. Now I will hand over to Varun.
In proposed methodology, the device is to be attached to the hook of the stand on which the IV bottle is placed. The pressure on the hook by the IV bottle level will in turn indicate the weight of the IV bottle level. This weight will then be used to evaluate the IV bottle level. As shown in the figure, the 1 kg load cell will continuously measure the weight of the IV bottle, which will be used to estimate the electrolyte level. The signal processor will amplify and convert the analog to digital signal. Then the microcontroller will be used to calculate the bottle level. User will be alerted when there will be 64 ml of electrolyte left in the bottle. The monitor terminal and the buzzer will be used to notify the user regarding the low IV bottle. In proposed requirement analysis, we have two types of requirements. First is the software requirements and second is the hardware requirements. In software requirements, we have used Proteus to design the circuit and we have used Arduino to implement the code. In hardware requirements, we have used Arduino Uno 1 kg load cell, HX711 24-bit dual channel load cell amplifier module, piezoelectric buzzer, LCD1602 parallel LCD display with IIC/I2C interface and printed circuit board. In impact analysis, our project has two types of impact. First is the impact on society and second is the impact on environment. Positive impacts are that this project will help reduce the health complications arising due to untimely checking of IV bottle level, and this device will help reducing the redundancy in the hospital staff's schedule, which will in turn make it possible for them to tend to critical priorities. Talking of negative impacts, in case of malfunctioning of the device, the staff might fail to notice the low electrolyte bottle level. Now, impact on environment. An impact on environment, first is the positive impact. A single device can alert multiple IV bottle levels, and in negative impact, the silicon used in the material might add to electronic waste. In professional ethical practices to be followed, first is data integrity. Data integrity means that no data which is gathered by this device is stored on any server. Second is transparency. Transparency is the efficiency and other parameters of this device are fully disclosed. Third is quality assurance. Quality assurance means that quality of the device should be on par. I now hand over to Vedant.
As can be seen in the presented figure, this is the circuit of our device. We have incorporated an LED, a buzzer, Arduino Uno microcontroller, a virtual terminal, an amplifier, and four resistances in Wheatstone bridge configuration. Now, these four resistances, which are in Wheatstone bridge configuration, are used to simulate the internal workings of a load cell. Changes in any one of their values generates a positive electric signal in direct proportion to the weight that is supposedly placed upon the load cell. Now, this electric signal is provided to the amplifier, which then in turn amplifies the signal and provides it as an input to the microcontroller. Now, the monitor terminal continuously displays the volume of the IV bottle. Once the IV bottle volume is at 64 ml or less, the buzzer and the LED turn on. This is the code implementation of the saline monitor. The variable sensor value stores the current value that is read by the load cell. It then displays that value. After that, we give a half a second of delay, after which we check if that value is less than or equal to 64 ml. If it is less than or equal to 64 ml, we turn on the LED, we turn on the buzzer, and we display an alert saying that the IV bottle level is low for about 5 seconds. So this right here is the status of the circuit when the IV bottle volume is high. As you can see, the current volume is 359 ml and the LED and the buzzer are off. On the other hand, here the status of the circuit, this is the status of the circuit when the volume of IV bottle is low. As you can see here, the volume is 61 ml and the LED and the buzzer are in on state. Now we'll move to the device demonstration. Now we are in the Proteus design software and I'll start the simulation. Now, as you can see, the current value of IV bottle is 963 ml. Now we'll decrease this value by decreasing the value of potentiometer RV3. As you can see, there is a decrease in the volume of IV bottle level. It is 189 currently, and the LED and the buzzer are off. Now remember, we have set the threshold of 64 ml. So let's see. Now it is 64 ml, and the buzzer and the LED are in on state for about 5 seconds. As well as we see that there is an alert that is being displayed on the virtual terminal. Now I'll stop the simulation and we'll return back to the presentation. In concluding this presentation, a device was designed to estimate the IV bottle level using load cell. An LED and a buzzer was used to notify when the IV bottle level was approximately 64 ml or less. This device can further be improved by adding a regulating mechanism in addition to the monitoring mechanism that is currently present in the system. These are the references. Thank you.